Welcome again to our FPCP Church at Home. Actually, it's our 18th week of worship. Parang nag-debut tayo, no? Under the COVID-19 virus pandemic. Pero kahit na merong ganitong klaseng, sabi nga, sinara ang church. Pero actually, hindi nasasara ang church. Yung building nasara, but the church is still alive. And hindi po, walang mintis, every Sunday, we're still worshiping together. Okay? Our worship continues. And sharing of the gospel continues. Even if it is ECQ or GCQ, MCQ, or no Q. No matter what happens, our worship will continue hanggang sa muling pagbabalik ng ating Panginoon. This is the day that the Lord has made, so let us rejoice and be glad in it. We have a reason to rejoice, to celebrate, because God is good. Do you believe that? God is good? Namimiss ko na to. God is good all the time. And all the time, yes, God is indeed good. Our good God wants us to give us a good life. Okay? His plans are good, pleasing, and perfect. Pero pwede natin tayo, pero bakit ganito buhay natin ngayon? Again, tinuturuan tayo ng Panginoon how to have a good life even in favorable and unfavorable circumstances. Even in this time of crisis, we can still have a good life. Pero ano nga ba talaga tong good life nito? Pero last week, you talk about how to live a godly life. And this godly life will result to a good life. Ulitin ko, godly life will result to a good life. Kaya in-equate natin, godly life is equal to a good life. Konting review lang po on how to live a godly life. To live a godly life is to first remember your identity. Sino ka ba? Ano bang relationship mo sa Diyos? Pangalawa, we have to wage war against our sinful desires. To live a godly life is to wage war against your sinful desire. Hindi pwedeng godly life pero sinful life. Hindi pwede. No? So we have to eliminate, we have to battle sinful desire. By the grace of God, to the power of the Holy Spirit, we can be victorious. Pangatlo, to live a godly life is to live to glorify God. That's godly life. It is for God's glory. You and I were created for the glory of God. Are we living for the glory of God? Pangapat, to live a godly life is to live as slaves of God. As slaves of God, ibig sabihin, alipin ka. Pero, being slaves of God is not a negative thing. Biro mo, yung master mo is the all-loving God, all-powerful God. He owns everything. He's all-knowing. Kaya, He knows our future. So, okay na. Kesa magpaalipin ka sa sarili mo, which is so imperfect, nagkakamali tayo. But if we have a perfect God, then it's okay. I'd rather be slaves of God. And actually, if we are slaves of God, we are free indeed. And lastly, to live a godly life is to live in reverent fear of God. Meron tayong banal na takot sa ating Panginoon. Again, this good life will result, this godly life will result to a good life. Today, our message is entitled, Good Life is Living a Godly Life. So, in-equate lang natin, good life is equal to a godly life. Before we continue, let's commit this time to the Lord. Let's pray. Again, Lord, teach us today. Open our ears, open our eyes, so that we can receive, so that we can encounter you through your word. Holy Spirit, come and fill this place. Wherever we are right now, in our homes, wherever we are, in our rooms, Lord, may you speak to us and may your word come alive so that we may encounter you. Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Okay. Of course, all of us wants to have a good life, okay, maayos at magandang buhay, especially in this time of crisis. Kaya nga tayo nagsusumikap, eh, no? Kaya nga tayo nagpapagod, okay? Para makabangon tayo, para tayo umangat at magkaroon ng maayos na buhay. But what is the Bible's description of a good life? Okay? Again, if we want to have a good life, we must live a godly life. And pag-usapan po natin muli ang 1 Peter chapter 2 verses 11 to 25. This is part 2 of our series. Okay? So, the question, what is a good life? Ano nga ba itong good life? And we will also evaluate, are we living a good life? Okay? Let's start with 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 12. Sabi dito, live such good lives among the pagans that though they accuse you of doing wrong, they may see your good deeds and glorify God on the day He visits us. Live such good lives among unbelievers. Sabi dito, kahit na daw ina-accuse sila, binabatikos sila of doing wrong, mali daw yung ginagawa nila, they may see your good deeds. Kahit na may kontra, kahit merong hindi maayos yung relationship, sabi, they will see your good deeds. Okay, and they will glorify God. First, what is a good life? Good life is doing good deeds. Okay? Ang magandang buhay ay gumagawa ng magandang gawa. Okay? So, you're having a good life, pero yung mga kilos natin, yung gawa natin ay hindi maganda. Parang hindi yata bagay, ano? Tuloy natin sa verse 17. Show proper respect to everyone. Love the family of believers. Fear God. Honor the emperor. So, tingnan, good life is doing good deeds. Ano yung good deeds na to? Good deeds is showing proper respect to everyone. That's a good deed. And if you're showing respect, that's a good life. Love the family of believers. Okay? If you have love, that is a good life. Okay? That is good deeds. Okay? Fear God. Honor the emperor. Mamaya, i-stress natin to, no? So, merong banal na takot sa Panginoon, and we have to honor the leaders, ano? Good deed shows respect, love, and honor to everyone. Take note, respect to everyone. Hindi daw selective. Okay? Hindi lang yung type mong mahalin o type mong sundin. Hindi lang yung type mong i-honor. Okay? It should be not selective. Why to everyone? Because everyone was created in the image of God. Okay? Yung we have to respect everyone. We have to love everyone. Because they have the image of God. So, tignan mo yung katabi mo ngayon. Ano? Yung asawa mo, yung anak mo. Yung anak mong yan, yung asawa mong yan, o kasambahay mo, or kung sino yung kasama mo sa bahay, your relative or your friend, they were created in the image of God. So, ang kailangan natin gawin sa kanila ay yung mabuting gawa to give them due respect, due love, because the one who created us is love, because God is love. Ngayon, balikan natin yung Ephesians chapter 2 verse 10. For we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. So we were created in Christ Jesus. Okay, si Jesus Christ daw ay nag-create sa atin. We were created by Him and for Him to do good works or do good deeds. Okay? So, since ito yung design sa atin, ito yung purpose natin to do good deeds or good works, ano kayang ginagawa natin? Again, good life is doing good deeds. Further sa Matthew 5:16, sabi, in the same way, let your light shine before men that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Para daw tayo ilaw ng sanlibutan. And that is a good life. Ito yung purpose natin, so that we can be the light of the world, so that they can see the good deeds. So ano kaya nakikita sa atin? Okay? At ang resulta nito, our Father, our God will be praised in heaven because of our good deeds. And that is the definition of good life. Pero kung babalikan natin si Peter, ano ba yung scenario, ano ba yung setting dito, no? We have to take note that Peter's readers, yung sinulat ni Peter, ito encouragement ni Peter, were scattered among unbelieving Gentiles. Okay? Mga hindi naniniwala sa Diyos, who were inclined to believe and spread vicious lies about Christians. So, during those times, yung mga sinulatan ni Peter, they were being persecuted. Okay? They were scattered all over. No? Nagkaalat sila. They were accused wrongly. Okay? Pinepersecute sila. Sinasaktan sila. And they were slaves, actually. Mga alipin sila. Pero sabi, kahit na alipin ka, kahit pinepersecute ka, you should show good deeds. Parang hirap yata yun, ano? Pero by God's grace, ito nga yung tinuturo sa atin. Good life. If you want to have a good life, we will do good deeds. Pangalawa, good life is submitting to the authorities. Okay, good life is submitting to the authorities. Imagine a lawless society. Okay? Wherein nobody is obeying the law or nobody's enforcing the law to each his own. Sabihin, kanya-kanya. Okay? Parang yung nangyari sa Amerika na may looting dito. Okay? Wala nang batas, wala nang sumusunod. Wala nang, hindi na nila re-respeto yung mga pulis, ano? Yung batas. What will be the outcome? Chaos. Gulo. Just imagine na, kung walang sumusunod. Imagine mo sa tahanan natin, ang mga anak natin hindi sumusunod. Okay? Yung trabahador natin hindi sumusunod sa iyo. Ano kaya mangyayari, di ba? So, but if you submit to the authorities, lahat kaya ay sumusunod. Ano kayang magiging picture? Ano kayang mangyayari sa bahay natin kung lahat ng mga anak natin ay sumusunod? Lahat ng mga nanay, ginagawa yung kanyang tungkulin. Lahat ng tatay, sumusunod sa Diyos. Nililid ang buong pamilya, setting a good example. Okay? At sumusunod sa batas. Ano kayang magiging picture? Diba? It will be a good life. A better life. 1 Peter 2:13, submit yourself for the Lord's sake to every human authority, whether to the emperor as the supreme authority. Okay. Ito, no? Maliwanag dito. Submit yourselves for the Lord's sake. Okay. Dahil in honor of God, in fear of the Lord, mag-submit ka. Kanino? To every human authority. Sino yung human authority? Whether to the emperor as the supreme authority. Ganito, we have to obey our leaders. Sino ba yung mga leaders natin? Umpisa natin sa presidente. Okay? Sabi dito, submit yourselves for the Lord's sake. Dapat sumusunod tayo sa presidente natin, sa ating mayor, sa barangay captain natin, sa pulis, di ba? Sa magulang natin, sa pastor natin, di ba? Sa leaders natin, or even dun sa street sweeper. Kasi they are in authority, no? Yung garbage collectors. Dapat nagsasubmit tayo everyday, nagtatapong kami ng basura, pero kailangan, may oras kasi ang pagkuha ng basura. At dapat maayos ang pagbigay. So, we have to submit to the authorities. Kahit sabihin mong basurero yan, dapat sumunod ka. Diba? Kahit janitor yan, they have their authority. Yun yung kanilang tungkulin at yun yung authority na dapat sumusunod tayo. Okay? Submit yourself for the Lord's sake. Ba't nating gagawin to? For the Lord's sake. Because the highest authority is God. At in-endorse ng Diyos yung mga leaders na yan. Okay? Tutuloy natin sa verse 14. Or to the governors who are sent by Him. Again, sent by Him. Sent by God to punish those who do wrong and to commend those who do right. So, that is the specific work of the authorities, to punish yung mga lumalabag sa batas and to commend those who do right. Pero bakit ba uso yung mga hindi sumusunod? Okay? Na have you found yourself na there are times na hindi tayo nagsasubmit sa authorities, lalo na sa pila, no? Sabi, dapat pumila. Dapat mag-wear ng mask. Social distancing. Hindi pwedeng maraming tao sama-sama sa isang kotse. Di ba? Isang sasakyan. Okay? Ba't tayo hindi sumusunod? Alam nyo, the reason is our pride. Yeah? It is difficult for us to submit. Meron tayong extreme democratic mindset. Ano yung extreme democratic mindset? We fight for our rights. Okay? Masyado tayo pinaglalaban natin yung ating karapatan. Okay? Ngayon, submission is actually bowing before the authority of others. Ibig sabihin, sumusuko ka, nagsasubmit ka, binibigay mo ang iyong sarili in submission to the authorities. Pero kung may pride ka, hindi mo gagawin yan. Hindi ka susunod eh. Bakit? Diba? We submit for the Lord's sake to every human authority. Again, not selective. Okay? Kapag may pwesto yan, in authority yan, sumunod ka. Okay? We don't need actually democracy. We need theocracy. Ulitin ko po. Hindi po solusyon para maging maayos ang bansa natin, democracy. Look at us, we have democracy, pero ang gulo-gulo ng bahay ng bansa natin. Look at America. Okay? Democracy, pinaglalaban ang democracy. Pero look what's happening. What we need is theocracy. Rule of God. Kasi isa sa inutos ng Panginoon, submit to the authorities. If we submit to God, we also submit to the authorities. Kasi yun ang tinuturo ng ating Panginoon, maliwanag na maliwanag dito. Okay? So, tuloy natin sa verse 15, ano? For it is God's will, okay? Kalooban daw ng Diyos, that by doing good, you should silence the ignorant talk of foolish people. Okay? Ito daw yung kalooban ng Panginoon para sa atin. This is God's will for you and me to do good. And this is a good life. Okay? And doing good here is all about submitting to the authorities. Again, we submit to the authorities because this is God's will. Okay? This is what God wants. Ito yung kagustuhan ni Lord. Kaya kapag nagsasubmit tayo sa Kanya, at nagsasubmit tayo sa authorities natin, alam nyo, this pleases God. Matutuwa si Lord sa atin. Sa verse 18, slaves, in reverent fear of God, submit yourselves to your masters, not only to those who are good and considerate, but also to those who are harsh. Ulitin po natin, ano? Importante po tayo. Ito, slaves, okay? During those times, maraming mga Jews ang mga naging slaves or even Gentiles, ano? Pero sabi ni Peter, slaves, okay? In reverent fear of God, submit yourselves to your master. Okay? Submit yourselves to your masters. Not only to those who are good and considerate, hindi lang doon sa mabait, but also to those who are harsh. Kahit doon sa mga malulupit, kahit masakit magsalita. Okay? Why we are doing this? Out of reverent fear of the Lord. We submit out of reverent fear dahil sa takot na may paggalang sa ating Diyos. So we submit to people because we submit to God. Many Christians during that time were household slaves. It would be easy to submit to masters who are gentle and kind, di ba? But Peter encouraged loyalty and perseverance even in the face of unjust treatment. In the same way, we should submit to our employers, whether they are considerate or harsh. By so doing, we may win them to Christ by our good example. So, ang trabaho pala natin ay mag-submit. Okay? Hindi natin pwedeng sabihin, kasi yung boss ko, ganyan ang ugali eh. No? Kasi ang tatay ko, ganyan eh. Hindi ka galang-galang. Sino ba namang re-respetohin mo kung ganyan ang tatay mo o ang nanay mo? Diba? Again, submit out of reverence or fear, reverent fear of God. Okay? Punta tayo dun sa Ephesians. Si Paul naman na nagsabi nito. Sa Ephesians 6:5, slaves, obey your earthly masters with respect and fear. With respect and fear. And with sincerity of heart, just as you would obey Christ. Okay? Equal yan. If you submit to Christ, you also submit to your authorities. Verse 6, Ephesians 6:6, obey them not only to win their favor when their eyes is on you, but like slaves of Christ, doing the will of God from your heart. Kahit daw, hindi lang daw kapag nakatingin sa atin, may nagbabantay, at saka tayo sumusunod. Okay? Doing, this is the will of God. Doing the will of God from, with sincerity from our hearts. Okay? Verse 7, serve wholeheartedly as if you were serving the Lord, not men. So, if you are serving someone sa trabaho mo or sa family, no, don't think, sabi, think about serving God, not just serving man. Naglilingkod ka sa Diyos. Yung ginagawa mo ngayon ay ginagawa mo para sa Diyos, hindi lang para sa tao. Okay? Kaya, balik tayo sa 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 19. For it is commendable if someone bears up under the pain of unjust suffering because they are conscious of God. So, sabi dito, it is commendable. This is good. This is approved by God. Okay? We submit kasi ito yung nararapat. This is good. And this is a good life. Okay? We submit because we are conscious of God. Okay? Submit to God, submit is to submit to God is to submit to the authorities. Okay? Parang this is an extension ng loving God, loving people. Submit to God, submit to others. Okay? Pero there is some limitations in submission. Okay, in earthly authorities. Ano 'yun? Yung limitation. Kailan ako hindi susunod if it goes against the authority of God? Siyempre si God ang superior, pinaka head natin, siya yung pinakamataas at inatasan niya ang mga government officials, ang ating mga magulang, anyone in authority. Pero kapag ang utos nila ay labag sa utos ng Diyos, then we submit to God rather than man. Kaya nga ito yung sinabi ni nila Peter, sabi niya, we must obey God rather than man. Pinapatigil silang mag-share ng gospel, mag-i-share si Jesus Christ. Sabi niya, we must obey God rather than man. Makikita natin sa Acts, Book of Acts, pinipigilan na silang mag-share, pero hindi, tuloy-tuloy pa rin sila because they submit to God because God is the highest authority. Okay? So, medyo ano ito, no? It will be a struggle for some of us. But remember this, We submit to God. If we submit to God, we will also submit to the authorities. Pangatlo, good life is willingness to endure suffering for doing good. Okay? Good life is willingness to endure suffering for doing good. Saan natin makikita yan? Sa verse 20. But how is it to your credit if you receive a beating for doing wrong and endure it? But if you suffer for doing good and you endure it, this is commendable before God. Okay. Yan sinasabi dito, no? Ano nga ba yun? Kung anong credit ang matatanggap mo? If you are beaten, naparusahan kasi nag-violate ka, hindi ka sumunod sa authorities. Ano yun? Okay? Dapat lang. But if you suffer for doing good and endure it, kahit na tama ka, pero mali ang accusation sa'yo, you suffer for doing what is right and good in the eyes of the Lord, and you endure it, sabi, this is commendable before God. God is pleased. So, good life is our willingness to endure suffering for doing good. Okay? Are we willing to suffer as we do what is right in the eyes of the Lord? To endure is to continue, to remain firm, not yielding in doing good, even if it is very difficult. Okay? Opposite nito is giving up or to quit or to stop. Parang ayoko na. Parang ayoko nang sumunod kay Lord. Ayoko nang gawin to. Okay? To the point na pwede tayo mag-retaliate, pwede tayo maging rebellious, okay, against the authorities. Nangyayari ba yan sa bahay? Nangyayari ba yan sa tahanan natin? Nangyayari ba yan sa office? Sabi, let's endure sufferings for doing good. This is the definition of God of a good life. Yan yung sinasabi rin ni Apostol Pedro. Okay? What will happen if we will not endure or simply give up? Ano mangyayari? Hindi, ayoko na. Ayoko nang gawin to. Okay? We rebel, we fight, we will be disciplined, and there will be greater conflict. Lalala, magkakaroon ng matinding problema, and we sin. Okay? Mas gugulo ang buhay natin. Take note that Christians were being persecuted by the authorities. Peter himself was martyred. Yung nagsulat nito na submit to the authorities, yung was willing to endure sufferings for doing what is right, he himself was martyred during the reign of Emperor Nero. Itong Emperor Nero ito, sikat ito eh. I-search nyo yun. In the church history, he hated Christians. He accused them of burning, okay? nag-arson dun sa Rome, ano? And made them, ginawa silang human torches, naka-barbecue doon sa ano, and then nakahilera yung mga patay na yung mga Christians, and they were burned alive. Okay? They were even fed to the lions. Grabe, no? He's suffering, pero tinuro niya. Okay? We must be willing to endure suffering for doing good. Hindi nila ipagkakanulo si Jesucristo. Si Pedro, remember? He denied Jesus Christ. Pero nung nag-resurrect si Jesus Christ, when he again encountered our Lord Jesus Christ, he made a commitment. Sabi ng Panginoon, feed my sheep. At 3 times inutusan siya ng Panginoon, feed my flock. Do you love me? Feed my sheep. Take care of my flocks. 3 times sinabi ng Panginoon yun. And that's what Peter did. He fed the flocks. He shared Jesus Christ kahit na maraming opposition, and to the point that he was martyred. Ang tawag doon, a good life. Why? Because he is pleasing our good Lord. Suffering is part of our calling. Okay? Suffering is part of our calling. Minsan parang ayaw natin nang maghirap tayo, no? Pero kasama yun eh. Bakit? Yung si Jesus Christ mismo, yung idol natin, ano? Okay lang maging idol si Jesus Christ because He is God. He suffered and He died. Tingnan niyo sa verse 21. To this you were called because Christ suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in His steps. Okay? We should follow the example of Christ who suffered for you and for me. We may suffer for many reasons. Some suffering in direct result of our sins, own sin. Some happens, some suffer because of our own foolishness. Some is a result of living in this fallen world. Peter is writing about suffering that comes as a result of doing good. Jesus is the perfect example. Okay, bilisan lang natin, ano? Jesus set an example. Sa verse 22, He committed no sin and no deceit was found in His mouth. Verse 23, when they hurled their insult at Him, He did not retaliate. When He suffered, He made no threats. Instead, He entrusted Himself to Him who judges justly. He entrusted Himself to His Father. Yan, yung idol natin, si Jesus Christ. He set an example of willing to endure suffering for doing what is good, doing the will of the Father. And this is a good life. And Jesus lived a good life. Hindi siya nagpakasasa. Imagine mo, no? He came from heaven. He went here on earth. Ano bang buhay niya sa langit? He sat on a throne. He was sitting in His throne. He has angels. He is God. Pero, He is willing to suffer for a purpose, and that is to save us, to die for us. Our goal should be to face sufferings as He did. Okay. Yung sufferings natin, well, totoo yan. Mahirap ngayon. Ano? Hindi na tayo nakakapanood ng sine. Wow, grabe yung sufferings natin. Ano? Hindi na tayo nakakapunta sa restaurants. Grabe yung sufferings na ba yun? Okay. Well, some of us, yes. Pero compared to our Lord Jesus Christ, we have not yet shed a drop of blood, okay, for doing what is good. Yes, we may encounter konting persecution, konting paglalait, pero we have to endure it. And even the difficulty of serving the Lord, we have to endure it for doing what is good. All who follow Jesus must be prepared to suffer. We must pay the price or the cost. Mark 8:34, then He called the crowd to Him along with His disciples and said, if anyone would come after Me, he must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow Me. Yung cross na ito, ito yung pinagagawa ng ating Panginoon sa atin, and we have to follow Him. Lastly, a good life is living for righteousness. Okay? Isang verse lang. A good life is living for righteousness. Sa verse 24, He Himself bore our sins in His body on the cross so that we might die to sins and live for righteousness. And by His wounds, you have been healed. Ulitin po natin, ano? He Himself bore our sins. Jesus Christ, sinalo niya yung ating mga kasalanan. He died for our sins in His body on the cross. Yung kanyang katawan. Kay sinalo lahat ng ating kasalanan. Yung kaparusahan na dapat sa atin, kinuha niya yun. Okay? Sinarili niya yun for us so that we might die to sin. Through His death, we also die to sin and live for righteousness. We should live for righteousness. Mabuhay tayo para sa katuwiran, para sa matuwid na buhay. And actually, righteousness dito is Jesus Christ Himself, that we should live for Christ. Okay? Because if we follow Christ, okay, this is a good life, this is a godly life. We already died to sin, therefore, we should now live for righteousness. We should live for Christ's sake. So this is the challenge, ano? Don't exchange your good life for anything that is less, for anything less. Yung good life natin is a godly life. Huwag po natin ipagpalit ito. So something that is less. Don't exchange your good life. Don't exchange to what you receive from our Lord Jesus Christ to anything that is less. Okay? Sabi sa 1 Peter 2:25, and this is our last verse. For you were like sheep going astray, but now you have returned to the shepherd and overseer of your soul. For you were like sheep going astray. Para daw tayong mga ligaw na tupa. Pero ngayon, we have returned to the great shepherd, and that is our Lord Jesus Christ, the overseer of our soul. This is a good life. A good life is living with the Lord. A good life is living with the great shepherd. Again, Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. That's a good life. Our great shepherd will take care of you. We have to put our life, we have to submit to Him. We have to have faith in Him. Don't go back from being lost or astray now that you have returned to the Lord. Again, huwag mong ipagpalit ang ating Panginoon. Huwag mong ipagpalit yung gift ng ating Panginoon. For God so loved you, again, that He gave His one and only Son, that if you ever believe in Him, you will not perish but have everlasting life. Huwag po nating sayangin yung ibinigay sa atin ng Panginoon. God is worth everything we have. And if we have Jesus, we have everything. So recap, what is a good life? Okay, taught by Apostle Peter, good life is doing good deeds. Good life is submitting to the authorities. Good life is willingness to endure suffering for doing good. Good life is living for righteousness. Let us live a good life and a godly life. Let us live a good life and a godly life, because living a good life is all about living a godly life. Gusto niyo po bang magkaroon ng maayos na buhay? We have to live a godly life. Ibigay natin ang ating buhay sa ating Panginoon, then we will have a good life. No matter what happens, we have to offer our life to God. Maybe you feel that right now, you're living the opposite of a good life. Bakit? Kasi siguro, mahirap ang buhay ngayon. Maybe wala kang trabaho, meron kang matinding problema, meron kang sakit, you have a problem with your relationship. God can give you a good life. Okay? He has given us His Son, and that is our good Lord, our good Shepherd. If you want to have a good life, we have to accept the good Lord in our lives and allow Him to live in our lives, and we have to follow Him. And that is equivalent to having a godly life. Okay? Let's submit to the Lord. Any worries, kung ano mang problema mo ngayon, this is good, this is pleasing, this is perfect. God wants us to submit ourselves to the Lord. Let's pray. Lord, we commit to You our lives. Lord, 18th week na namin dito sa pandemic na ito. Some of us are suffering. Some of us are iba na yung nararamdaman ngayon. May fear, may uncertainty. Yung iba sa amin, hindi na namin alam kung anong gagawin. Pero You promised us, You gave us a good life. And that good life is through our Lord Jesus Christ. And to live a good life is to live a godly life. But this will all start if we have a personal relationship with you. And we would like to invite you again, Lord Jesus Christ, to come in to our lives. The Good Shepherd should be in our lives. The Good Shepherd should take care of us. That's why I'm challenging each one of us. Allow the Good Shepherd to take control of our life so that we can have a good life. Let's invite Him right now. Our Good Shepherd, our good Lord, our good God, come into my life. Take charge of my thoughts. Take charge of my emotions. Take charge of my will, of my body, my spirit, everything about me. Because if you are in us, in my life, we will have a good life. If we will submit to you, we will have a good life. Come in, Lord Jesus. Take control of our lives. Invite Him right now. Come, Lord Jesus. Take control of my life so that I can have a good life. In Jesus' name I pray, amen and amen. Part of a good life is about giving to our good God. If you have a good life, we have to give to our good God. So why do we give our tithes and offerings? It is an expression of our thanksgiving to God. So, were you blessed by the Lord? I believe pinagpala tayo ng Panginoon in many, many ways. And yung tithes and offerings natin, it's an expression of our thanksgiving to our good God. Sabi sa 2 Corinthians 9:11, you will be made rich in every way so that you can be generous on every occasion. And through us, your generosity will result in thanksgiving to God. Alam nyo, si Lord ang nagbibigay sa atin ng blessing. What you have right now, yung trabaho mo, yung sasakyan mo, what we have enjoying right now is from the Lord. Okay? And sabi niya, He will make you rich in every way. Hindi lang financially, but also rich spiritually, rich in relationship, so that you can be generous on every occasion. He will bless you so that you can be a blessing to others, so that you can also bless the Lord. And through us, your generosity will result to thanksgiving to God. Ay, sabi ni Paul, through us, yung workers, yung generosity mo will result to thanksgiving to God. Okay? Sa verse 12, this service that you perform is not supplying the needs, is not only supplying the needs of God's people, but is also flowing, also overflowing in many expression of thanks to God. So, this is an expression of thanksgiving to the Lord. Okay? So, dito pinapakita ng Panginoon that He will bless you. Okay? Mightily. Okay? You will be made rich in every way so that you can be generous. And what we will be doing now as we give our tithes and offerings, this is an expression of our thanksgiving to our God. So before you pass the offering, siguro mga tatay, again, you lead in prayers. Okay? Thanksgiving to our God. And let's sing this song as we give our offering.